Your Excellencies, Mr. Sabananda Sunawal, Chief Ministers of the State of Assam.
Your Excellencies, Mr. K.J. Alphon, Minister of Tourism, Independent Church, Government of India. Your Excellencies, Mr. Nongthomban Biran Singh, Chief Minister of Manipur. Madam Vijay Thakur Singh, Secretary East, Ministry of External Affairs, Government of India. Major General Dhruv Kathoch, Director of India Foundation. Distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon. It is a great honor for me to be here today in the beautiful city of Guwahati for the second ASEAN-India Youth Summit. The summit is a sound example of our commitment to lay a solid foundation and to ensure that ASEAN-India ties remain strong in future times when the youth, our future leaders, stand tall at the helm of our great nations. The first ASEAN-India Youth Summit was successfully conducted in August 2017 in Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh state, and witnessed the birth of ASEAN-India Youth Declaration. The declaration embodied the aspiration among youth from ASEAN and India on the common vision of peace and prosperity, and in light of such spirit, I'm eager to learn what our youth have for us in store today. Since the commencement in 1992, ASEAN-India relations have made significant progress and expanded to cover a wide range of areas, including political security, economic and social cultural cooperation, and was subsequently elevated to a strategic partnership since 2012. Our collective commitment to promoting peace, stability, and prosperity in the region is a shared strategic vision and cornerstone of ASEAN-India relations. Up to this day, ASEAN and India collaboration have also been characterized by strong cultural as well as historical link through the convening of many collaborative activities. With the theme connectivity is the pathway to shared prosperity, the second ASEAN-India Youth Summit is a significant initiative for promoting connectivity that is essential in meeting the goals of the ASEAN-India Partnership for Peace, Progress, and Shared Prosperity. Initiatives like this deepen the ties and mutual understanding among the youth as well as between ASEAN and India. Connectivity also enhances trade and investment, and enables sharing of innovative researches and solutions, promote good practices that improve governance and financial inclusion through technology, and strengthen human capital development through mobility and share of talents and skills. The realization of our commitment in nurturing partnership and shared prosperity has been evident through collaborative initiatives such as the establishment of the ASEAN-India Network of Think Tanks, ASEAN-India Science and Technology Development Fund, ASEAN-India Business Council, collaboration in the field of blue economy, and foremost reflected in the trade growth between our regions. The total trade between ASEAN and India doubled in the last decade from 38.4 billion in 2007 to 73.5 billion in 2017. The adoption of the Delhi Declaration during the ASEAN-India Commemorative Summit last year, among others, reaffirmed the commitment of both ASEAN and India in strengthening the bond among our youth through education, highlighting the theme, Share Values, Common Destiny. The pinnacle of the 25th anniversary of ASEAN-India dialogue relation was Prime Minister Narendra Modi's announcement of the grant of fellowship for students from ASEAN country to study at one of the most prestigious education institutions in India, the Indian Institute of Technology. The Indian ASEAN Highway Professional Training Program and the promotion of university to university exchanges to promote student mobility and research. In times when disruption are becoming overarching themes of the century, these much anticipated efforts enrich ongoing ASEAN-India cooperation in higher education, such as the Goodwill Scholarship and the Nalanda University Scholarship. For this, we are truly grateful for the support from our good friends in India. Distinguished guests, the youth of today must be resilient more than ever. The many disruptions in our society must be dealt with in a manner that enables our youth to be adaptive, responsive, nimble, and vigilant. From natural disasters and social tension to digitalization and automation, unprecedented events continue to emerge and affect the way we live, interact, and go about our daily lives. It is for this reason that whatever youth development measure we take is geared toward instilling the necessary skills and mentality for our youth to progress in the evolution of the future workforce. The focus of youth development should go beyond hard technical skills, but also soft skills that allow them to adapt well to rapid changes in the futures. I believe that this is very much relevant with what ASEAN and India envision when strengthening cooperation among ourselves. It is our desire to reassure that the future leaders and caretakers of our great nation are equipped with essential skills and values that will bring peace and prosperity into the region and beyond. It is therefore evident that our youth will remain at the centers of our development agenda as they are our futures. Fostering youth connectivity and the value of shared prosperity among our youth can be nurtured by encouraging their participation in meaningful community building activities across our region. There are many examples of ASEAN-India collaboration where youth participation can be enhanced to bring out the positive characteristics and values of being a good global citizen. A good example to build on would be India's support in establishing digital villages in Cambodia, Lao PDO, Myanmar, and Vietnam, using India gigabit passive optional network technology. It would be interesting to explore how the youth of ASEAN and India could partake in efforts to improving information and communication technology, as well as promoting digital literacy and rural entrepreneurship in the villages by introducing innovation and problem-solving skills to the local youth communities as well. My fellow youth, your role in addressing global issues, preserving the benefit of social development and the prosperity to share is increasingly wanted. With the majority of you being IT savvy and digital native, voicing your idea toward our community building efforts, as well as becoming agents of behavioral change, should no longer be a major challenge. It is also desired upon you to lend a hand and amplify the efforts of our region in building a community that is sustainable, inclusive, dynamic, resilient, and most important of all, benefits the people. One of the challenges in our community building efforts is climate change. Realizing how climate change heightens the frequency and intensity of natural disasters, the ASEAN leaders adopted the ASEAN Declaration on the adoption of the ASEAN Youth in Climate Action and Disaster Resilience Day during the 33rd ASEAN Summit in November 2018. The declaration set a commitment to strengthen youth participation in climate change adaptation and mitigation, and also disaster risk reduction. It also declares 25th November as an important day for you, that is the ASEAN Youth in Climate Action and Disaster Resilience Days. The first commemoration was held by the Philippines, whereby the National Conference of Youth organized a simulation of the annual conference of the parties to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change and selected top 10 youth-led climate action. We are hopeful that the commemoration of this declaration this year will be more impactful, and we very much look forward to the possible collaboration between the youth of India and ASEAN in this endeavor. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, Mahatma Gandhi once said, "Be the change that you want to see in the world." Rest assured that what we are fostering through the ASEAN-India Youth Summit is not to project our hopes and expectation to you, our youth, but to assist you in realizing a future that is yours to envision, yours to own, and yours to pass down to the next generation of hopeful youth. Last January, ASEAN-India tourism ministers declared the year 2019 as the ASEAN-India Tourism Cooperation Year. I would like to use this opportunity to reaffirm that ASEAN is looking forward to enhancing cooperation with India in increasing two-way tourist visit and promoting greater people-to-people exchanges between ASEAN and India. I also look forward to the fruition of the ASEAN-India tourism training programs in the sharing of resources and facilitate further the connectivity between our hospitality industry and the tourism educator involved. It is also my hope that the ASEAN-India Youth Summit today would contribute to enriching the ASEAN-India strategic partnership and elevating it to new heights. I would like to end my remark by thanking Chief Ministers and Minister of Tourism and also the organizer for inviting us here today and also for hosting, you know, warm hospitalities to all of the young people from the ASEAN regions. And I wish that for the next 2 or 3 days, you will gain a lot of ideas and insights. And build on this, you will connect with one another through technology. I'm sure after this, you probably, you know, wire up with one another with some sort of apps or online application, and then maintain the relationship and share, you know, what you have and learn from each other's. And build on this, you can contribute more to the efforts of all the ASEAN members in, you know, ensuring that this community will provide all the benefits to our peoples. So once again, thank you very much, and wish you all a fruitful and successful summit. Thank you.